Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the melody series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. Today I'm going to show you how to make dark trap melodies using FL Studio stock plugin. So this plugin is called Sakura and the preset is called Pluck Natural Harp. And we're going to hit Control L to send that to the mixer. So here's the melody I created. Now there is a mathematical way to explain this. I just happened to play it by accident on the keyboard, but it sounded really good, and there's a reason why. So firstly, we have to understand that chords make up melody. Melody is composed of multiple notes, and most of the time, those multiple notes derive from harmonization, notes that go together. So in this case, we're really just playing ACE, which is A minor. So it's a minor chord. We're just playing it in different patterns. So instead of just playing it like this, the typical way, which is just A, C, E, as most people would just play it that way, we're playing it so that the third is played first, then we play the A note down an octave. So we're not even playing it that way. We're playing A down an octave. So really, it's all about the voicing of this chord. And this is the cool part about understanding chords, is that you can apply it to melody directly. So instead of going up an octave, where the A would be right there, we play it down an octave. So we're playing the third of the chord, which is just C. Then we're playing the root note down an octave. Then we're playing the root note again up an octave. So it goes. So we're playing the same notes. And this is what I mean by you have to understand chords first if you want to understand good melody. Then we go to the fifth in the chord ACE. But instead of playing the E in its normal position, we play it down an octave. Even just playing ACE going up, but playing the E in the bottom instead of the top sounds cooler to me for a minor. And that's because going for dark trap, it's all about going downward. Okay? That sounds a lot more dark than. Okay, so sometimes just going downward creates that dark vibe. Now all I did here was just strum in a certain human timing. If you draw in the notes, I'll show you a couple things you could do to get more human timing. So the first thing is, let's copy this and then quantize this so we could show you before and after. Let's hit Alt-Q to quantize. Now we're gonna highlight just these notes. Now the first thing people do is they leave the velocity all at the top. So if you hit Alt, you can left click and change the velocity to be reset. And they wonder why their melodies don't sound like cool. It's because everything is playing at the same velocity and the human ear needs change. So let's hit Alt R and let's turn off pattern mode. Let's go to levels and mess with the velocity knob here and hit accept. So that will give you a better randomness. Now you can go through and try to mimic, you know, the timing and the, for the most part, it's pretty similar to what I've recorded on the left. Now from here, I have the velocity changes cool, but it's too loud of an articulation it's called. So the harder you play the note, it has a different tone. So if you hit Alt X, you can actually turn down the multiply knob to keep the same distance in the velocity, but not trigger the same articulation. So it's not as bright. And that sounds very close. So let's play the first one next to the second one. The second one actually sounds better because it's quantized. So some people tell you to play by hand, but for trap music, I found that quantizing is just the sound of trap, the same way auto-tune is the sound of pop music. It's just something that we're used to hearing. But if you did want to add a little human timing to it, you could highlight all these notes, hit Alt-S. Now you would have to have notes which are stacked up for this to work. But you could hit Alt, like if I had some notes like this. Just drawing those in for an example. Let's turn these down. And highlight all these notes, hit Alt-S, and see how the notes are moving. Okay, that E note. So it just strums notes which are stacked. Okay, so it makes it more like, feel like a real instrument. It's actually a pretty cool extension to it. I like that. Let's save that. And let's copy this. So this is the better one. So let's get rid of the first. Let's copy this over. And take out these notes that I added. Now I move these around so these should be quantized again. Hit Alt-Q. See how we now have a more dynamic experience? Okay, so on top of this, you could add different effects. Okay, you can add, let's add some stock plugins. Let's go to Fruity Delay 3. Where are we at? Fruity Delay 3. And let's turn it on. And we're going to turn the dry level all the way down. We're going to turn the feedback level all the way down and the delay time all the way down. Now every other knob becomes a sound effect. So let's mess with the time modulation. This creates that pitch wobble effect. Okay, so we have that. Also, you can add some lo-fi effects like lowering the sample rate. And then you can use a low-pass filter to get rid of some of that high-end buzz. There's another way to do it, but I don't want to make this video too long. We teach all this stuff at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Now from here, we really don't need anything. I mean, reverb, maybe. You know, we don't need anything else really outside of this. But what you could add is gross beat if you're going for like a halftime type of sound. You go to presets, go to momentary, just go to half speed. You can blend it in with this knob. So it's optional, don't have to do that. Also what we could do is just add like a stutter. Now for this, I like to mess with the volume mix so it doesn't affect the whole sound. Just adds like a little jumpiness to it. So these are all different options for you, okay? We teach you a lot more in the Melody series. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Thanks for watching today. It's Game from busyworksbeats.com.